There's no AP exam for college algebra or college tree, just for calculus. Alright, y equals x is a first degree polynomial. We are going to learn in this class right now how to deal with polynomials. This is the very last sheet of notes, so you can either tear it off or use the back, it's up to you. But the fact is, we know what this graph looks like. It goes up. If it's negative, it's a line that goes down. And we just visited a unit dealing with second degree polynomials, and we called those parabolas. We graphed them, we had them in standard form, we had them in vertex form. And we moved them all around the place, and you guys are very familiar with those. But what about larger degree polynomials, such as third, fourth, and fifth degree? Yes, we could talk about sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. The fact is that after we get to fifth degree, honestly, sixth, seventh, and eighth, it really doesn't come up that much in terms of what we're preparing for. So third degree is y equals x to the third, and you are used to the graph looking like this parent function. However, when we add things to the x to the third, when we put in x squareds and x and constants along with it, what happens is we get what we call this hidden behavior, and you might get a shape that looks like that. It's got a couple of bumps in it. Okay, that's if it's positive. If it's negative, it may look something like that. A fourth degree polynomial looks something like a W shape. Now, as you can see by looking at this, it has a, three bumps to it. It doesn't necessarily have to have that many. You might see a shape that looks something like this, and this is still a fourth degree polynomial. And then a fifth degree polynomial, we just continue to add another bump. So it's something like that. Or if it's negative, and I'm going to take out one of the bumps, that would be an example of a fifth degree polynomial right there. We're going to use this drawing, and you really want to look at mine because I have the advantage of having colors and you don't, in order to make some different conjectures about the behavior of these polynomials. Okay, we're going to start by talking about local extrema. Local extrema are the bumps in the graph. They are the local maximum, local minimum. Maxes and mins are extreme values, so they call them extrema. So local extrema for a polynomial. All right, time to make conjectures. What degree? How many bumps? What degree? How many bumps? Degree? Bumps? Degree? Bumps? So if it had a degree of n, at most how many bumps would it have? N minus 1. So given a polynomial of degree n, there are at most n minus 1. It doesn't have to have exactly n minus 1. It could be less than that, but at most it would have n minus 1. Okay? So you can actually look at these graphs and then characterize, well, it's probably, by looking at the graph, it's probably a fourth degree polynomial. It's possible to have this shape and actually have, say, an eighth degree polynomial or things like that, but to say it's a fourth is a good start. Okay. Next piece we have to master. Please look at all the green functions. What do the green ones have in common? They're all positive. So they're all positive. And as x goes in this direction, okay, do the functions finish, the functions that are green, do they finish going up or down? So if they're positive, they finish up. So whether or not the degree is odd or it's even, as long as it is positive, as x goes towards infinity, it finishes up. Now, that's not a very mathematical thing to write, just an arrow going up. So let's press ourselves and think of something a little bit more mathematical. As x goes to positive infinity, y would go to positive infinity. So y also goes to infinity. Let's consider if it's negative. Look at all the blue functions. All the blue functions finish going down. Let's use something other than blue arrows going down to show and express what's happening. As x goes towards positive infinity, y goes towards negative infinity. This is the first time you've written the infinity symbol, isn't it? Kind of fun. You feel really smart. It's like, ooh, always wanted to do that. Anybody have a really bad infinity symbol? Okay, all right. So, you know, you're wondering what to do on a Friday night. You're with some friends. Sit down and practice together. Have a contest. Now you're making fun of me. All right. Okay. Now we want to consider where it starts. So as x goes towards negative infinity, we look at the other side. Let's look at all the green functions. Actually, no, forget about that. let's look at the odd. Let's look at the even function. Which ones are even? Second and fourth. Look at this. The green and the blue, the green and the blue. Okay? What do you notice about where they start and where they finish? They start and finish in the same direction. If they're even, starts up, finishes up. Starts down, finishes down. Starts up, finishes up. Starts down, finishes down. So what we know about even functions is that if it finishes up, it starts up as well. And if it finishes down, it starts down. Consider the odd functions, first, third, and fifth. What do you notice about where they finish and where they start? Opposite. So if n is odd and it finishes up, it starts down. And same way here, if it finishes down, it will start up. I don't think you'll necessarily come back to that chart, but helping us to think through the behavior is an important step. You will probably look at these, and you will definitely look at this part moving forward. Let's talk about the last part here. Something that's very important about the behavior of polynomials has to do with their roots. The term x-intercept is synonymous with these. Root, zero, solution. If you see those words come up, it's most likely referring to the x-intercept. The MCA, the ACT, the AP exam, they'll all use those terms interchangeably, so will your book. So I have an example of a single root here. This is an example of a single root. And what happens with a single root is it just crosses the x-axis. Goes right through. I also have an example of a double root. How would you describe a double root? Yeah, it touches and goes back up. Kind of like what shape? A parabola. Double root, second degree. Kind of see that? Single root, kind of like a line. Okay. So it's going to touch and it's going to come back up if it's a double root. Oop, that was bad. Okay, and then we have an example here. We actually have two of them of triple roots. How would you describe a triple root? It kind of make that cubic shape of the parent function, doesn't it? It definitely passes through, but it flattens out right as it's passing through. So these are behaviors that are very important to learn to draw, because we are going to be graphing these. And you remember me saying before, and even as we talked about the test, about thinking of the graph, thinking about the square root of x minus 5, what does it look like? And when you see polynomials in the future, you want to be able to suggest what they look like. So we turn to the very front of your notes. And we start today by graphing polynomials. When you graph a polynomial, we should start by identifying what degree it will be. These are already factored for us, so they're pretty straightforward and easy. What would you, what's the degree of this one? Second degree. When we multiply it out, will it be positive or negative? Positive. Will this then finish up or finish down? It will finish up. Okay. So knowing those three things will really help me then make the graph. The one other thing I want to know is what are the roots or the solutions or the x-intercepts? And so I mark off those three spots or those two spots. And that's where it crosses. And these are all single roots. And so it will finish up. So it will start up because it's even. If it's an even polynomial, a parabola, if it's even, it will start and end in the same direction. And this is the type of logic I go through when I do each one. The next one, what degree? Third degree. Will it be positive or negative? So it will finish going down. What are the roots or the solutions? Negative 4, 1 and 5. Mark it out. This is going to finish going down. So where will it start? Up. We don't know how high or how low to draw the extrema. That would only happen when we take calculus, when we find out what that hidden behavior actually looks like. But overall, it's a pretty good graph. We'll do examples 3 and 4, and then we'll be done for the day. You do not have an assignment, but you do have a lengthy one tomorrow. I saw a sigh of relief from many people. You got a busy life or something? Okay. God. All right, what's the degree of 3? 3. Let's finish off these two. We got a minute here. We can do this, okay? What is it going to be, positive or negative? So it's going to finish up. So what are my solutions? 1, 0, and negative 5. So I mark them. It's going to finish up, so it's going to start down. And that's what it looks like. Now, our last example, what degree? Third degree, positive or negative? It will be negative when we multiply it all out. It's going to finish down. What are my roots? 0 and negative 4 happens twice. If you were to write this as x plus 4 times x plus 4, you would list that twice. Whatever degree it is, that's the number of solutions we will write. So therefore, as you mark this out, I want you to see this last piece. It crosses through there, it crosses through there. That's a double root. So what will it do at the double root? If it finishes down, it will start. So I touch tangent and I come back down. And so that's the type of behavior we want to focus on as we look tomorrow. If you end up late to your class, just run and get to class. So let's just do that, okay? All right, assignment tomorrow.